We're live back with another wind farming video today, playing on the early access Immortal Empires build for some general clarification on what exactly we'll be seeing today. First of all, I do not have any access to the DLC, and we are going to be watching some pre-recorded videos, as sadly we have to sort of make sure that we don't accidentally show stuff that we're not allowed to show. So that means that unfortunately I won't be picking requests from the audience, but we will be seeing quite a few games today against a ton of different content creators. Starting off, we're up against Dov Plays, playing as the Dark Elves, up against the glorious Warriors of Chaos on a new domination map. Yeah, this is going to be a very exciting today. I don't think we have any Vampire Coast, though I do want to get them in eventually. We will be doing more of these videos as time goes on, and hopefully it goes well. I forgot the classic win counter. I should probably slam that in there real quick. You'll also notice that the spell kit on Marathi is quite interesting. And that is because a lot of the spells have changed. For those of you that don't know, Power and Darkness does give 20 winds of magic now to your pool, which is a little bit bonkers, but you know, what can you do? And yeah, I think that's basically everything we need to go into. We can start going into this game. You'll notice Dov also has a couple different units of spawn over there. One of them conspicuously has shields. And that is because Chaos can now mark their units in multiplayer. It's amazing. Yeah, it's gonna be pretty great. Yeah, we will actually, I think I do have some Tomb Kings games in here, so that should be quite exciting. And for the build today, yeah, just what Marathi needed exactly. For the build today, I've gone for a skirmish build, but honestly, you know, we're not talking technicals today. We're just sort of enjoying the game. Power and Darkness does barely any damage to your troops too. So for a free 20 winds of magic, it's pretty good. Creative Assembly knows about it, definitely getting nerfed, but for now we're gonna enjoy how bloody OP it is. All right, I'm keeping a close eye on chat too, since I'm not actually managing the game right now, which means that we'll get a little bit more interaction today, sort of relaxing and just enjoying the fact that I can finally talk about Immortal Empires. Oh my gosh. Devolve is still broken. They know about it. It should be fixed by launch, if I had to guess, but no promises. Does Marathi have any Slaanesh units in her roster? Well, we will see some roster shenanigans later today. I guess I might as well bring up now, Sigvald is accessible on the Slaanesh roster. This is pretty big. Pretty big. Marathi not, though. Unfortunately. Yeah, Dark Elf, so hype. You can see, I got the classic build. We got the Manticore summons. Archaon, too, got a model change. Unfortunately, I don't do much zooming in when I play multiplayer, but he's looking pretty good. Pretty good. This map, too, is insane. There's a huge forest in the middle. Capture points are super far away. So mobility's sort of good, but because of all the forests everywhere, it gets really janky. This map plays differently to basically every other map that you've ever seen. Oh, I forgot. I should advertise. I should probably advertise this. Let's see. Let's see. Add everyone. We're alive. There we go. Nice. But yeah, this, I gotta say, domination with the Immortal Empires factions, amazing. It's such a different change of pace. Like, you never see this sort of full skirmish style ever. It's so good. Yeah, Sigvald is in both Warriors of Chaos and Slaanesh. And another fun thing, as you might have seen on Lore Master of Sotek stream, you can now take Vlad and Isabella as heroes, which is pretty cool, because now you can take Manfred as your lord, Vlad and Isabella as your two heroes, and you got, like, the ultimate Doom Squad. This is what Lore Master of Sotek did. I think he streamed it already, so I'm fine saying that. And even more funny, you can take Vlad as your lord and Vlad as your hero at the same time. So you double dip on the Vlad. It's amazing. That's probably going to get changed with unit caps. But, you know, for now, that's what we have in the current build. It is development in progress, as you can see in the top left, which is great. We see Lore Master of Sotek with the raid. Oh my gosh, thank you so much. Flood in the Twitch chat just as we start the stream. Yeah, I was just talking about your Vlad and Isabella shenanigans. Hilarious, man. Hilarious. Oh my goodness. This build is great. Hello everybody in Twitch. There's not enough of me. I got no meat on me, guys. You don't wanna... I'll barely fill your bellies at all. For everyone on YouTube that's confused, Twitch chat is going crazy right now. But yeah. Yeah, Vlad has undergone mitosis, indeed. Hey, hello everyone. Now, for this actual game, you'll notice we're still losing pretty badly to Chaos. We're trading down because of the spawn. And I think this map in general, probably not the greatest for skirmishers, but there's two maps. Here it is, two maps for domination incoming. That is gonna be just they're so different. They're so different from the other domination maps. One, extremely tight chokes with forests everywhere. It's pretty different from the other ones that use other terrain pieces. But for the other one, it's Black Arc Landing, which is just the biggest map you've ever seen for domination. I think that one will be so good for skirmish playstyles. I'm so excited to play on that. Also, you'll notice that Morath is getting Spirit Leeched, by the way, as I believe Archaon does actually have Spirit Leech now. He has access to the other lores of magic. Finally, it's not just the lore of fire, but he doesn't have any of the, demon exclusive lores in multiplayer, at least as far as I can remember. It's just like a mix of the generic lores. But still pretty cool. And you can see I'm trying to snipe him over here. Honestly, there's so much to talk about. I don't need to analyze this game. Croesus is hungry, he needs more meat. You guys are still talking about Croesus? By the way, since Lore Master of Sotek is around, remember to check him out. He also has access to Immortal Empires, making tons of videos too. So it's pretty good. Oh my gosh. Yeah, nice cast on the Lord. I think I missed with my Doombolt, right? I think he barely dodged it. Dov is totally wrecking me though, by the way. Dov is basically spawn camping me. This map is... He just piled on, and now my skirmishers have nowhere to dodge. But... you know, I can summon in some Slaanesh's Harvesters and get a pretty mean Soul Sealer on him. And at this point, I believe, yes, we are now actually catching up on value. So all I have to do is capture all the points in time before we run out. And it's going to be a race for that. Does unit stats change from Warhammer 2 to 3? They do. They do, and I'll be covering a ton of the changes in future videos. I actually have a Lord Croak video coming on up that we'll be showcasing as Lord Croak. Pretty busted. You'll see it. You'll see it in a bit. It's gonna be amazing, man. Is this content creator only early access? Indeed. So only for Creative Assembly partners. And soon enough, hopefully, we get everybody else in here as fast as possible. Was Croesus buffed? I didn't check. There's like a million things to look at, but soon enough. I'm gonna be posting a video every single day until Immortal Empires comes out. So I should be able to cover at least most of the things. Lots of the content creators are doing their own thing too. So yeah. Yeah, we have a lot of content. We're free to post as many videos as you want. I could post 2 videos in a day if I wanted to, but unfortunately my ability to create videos is not that fast. Is capture weight different in this build? Yes, it actually is. So for all of you hardcore multiplayer folk in here, capture weight acts differently. Infantry and cavalry capture at capture weight 4. Previously, infantry were at 6, so they got reduced by 30%. And cavalry was boosted to now be the same as infantry, which is also 4. Everything else is 3, and expendable units are also at 3. So basically, you don't have to worry about capture weight shenanigans as much. If you have 5 units on the point, and they have 5 units on the point, it's basically going to be the same weight. Which means, and chaff will be slightly less. So overall, it means that factions like Cathay, as many of you guys know, the ultimate meme, Cathay can actually capture points now. They can actually, if they have 4 peasant horsemen on the point, compared to, I don't know, like 4 corn warriors, they can actually defend it, which means they might actually be useful now. But we'll see. We'll see. Hold your thoughts. Hold your thoughts. We don't know for sure yet if they will actually be good. As As who knows, there's always a chance for Cathay to be terrible, I think. Battle ready. Waiting for the dwarf first dwarf mirror. Oh, that's going to be amazing. Oh, by the way, quick question. Is my microphone peaking? Is the quality good? Because I can turn it down like a smidge. Because I know I'm speaking louder because I'm just so excited to finally show this off. And you'll also see, unfortunately, yeah, there we go. I do concede the fight as we just fell behind. I was barely going to capture the points, but we didn't get there. Which means one loss. Content creators versus Inticity actually throwing some punches. That's going to be the first loss of today, but we have many games this time around, and I will definitely not be holding back my punches for many of these fights. Though Dov did take a pretty good build. You can see the hilariousness there of having four of each, one of each spawn from the Chaos Foster, and right away we're instantly back into the next match. It's going to be the High Elves against the Khorne champions. It's going to be a ton of Khorne warriors, and I've bought myself a princess and actually a lot more infantry than you would see from the High Elf side. Yeah, it's so fast. It's oh my gosh, how are we queuing so fast? I guess for people just tuning in, this is pre-recorded to make sure that we don't accidentally, you know, show anything that we're not supposed to. So yeah, such is the way of things, so it's just gonna be hands off for now. But pretty good, pretty good. Now my theory is this, the Phoenix Guard are pretty good in melee, you know, especially if they're getting heals. They have a lot of HP, so the healing should be quite effective on them, and hopefully they can kill Khorne warriors. They are a lot more expensive, so fingers crossed that works out. Yeah, woodsmen units, so good on this map. They're going to be bonkers good. Oh my gosh, it's going to be great. Someone's saying, at Intisti, that foe's CA themselves spoiling things. Oh yeah. Yeah, for anyone who didn't see Creative Assembly, check out the end of the video that they recently posted. I won't dig into it myself, but hilarity ensues. Marcus for the 5 USD, thank you very much. Every little bit helps get me closer to doing this full-time, proper, and yeah, it's great. Saying thanks for the coverage. Thank you for showing up, man. Happy to have so many people here today. Jeez, this is, I'm pretty sure we hit a new record. If we didn't, I'd certainly be surprised. And yeah, for this game today, it's going to be a standstill. You can see Dov is actually a little bit worried about engaging there, as I'm pretty sure my guys would win. Now we're fighting on the flank. I've brought some skirmishers and even glorious dragon princes that will be hopefully killing off the corn dogs, as we call them, flesh hounds, as most people call them. I'm telling you, corn dogs is better. And yeah, that's sort of the plan. I'm really hoping dragon princes will do it. I know most Kislev cavalry do, so the odds are quite likely. Yeah, this is indeed domination. We will even have a couple land battles, which is great. And actually, you can see the cavalry do pretty well here. Now, he's going to be sending in, I believe those are Skull Crushers of Khorne. One of the Crushers, something expensive cavalry. And we're going to be sending in our Dragon Princes to try and deal with them. Let's see how that matchup does. Dragon Princes don't trade super duper well on account of not having a ton of armor piercing. But because of healing, I think we should be fine. Plus, the dragon is nearby. By the way, dragons did get buffed. Amazing. Dragons, they got an increase to mass and HP. Understood. Which is great. Do you have a static goal for this is my job now? If I can increase my income by about like 100%, then we'll be, then I can fully say that it's my job. Which is actually pretty close. That's a lot further than many people ever reach. So I'm very thankful for that. What's it? Fast win. Nice, very nice name with the 50 Norwegian kroners saying, show us some broken stuff. I will. Have you seen my recent video on the vampire counts? Vampire counts Graveguard heal for 50 HP a second now. For reference, in Warhammer 2, if you stacked all of the healing, they only healed for like 12 HP a second, maybe 16. Which means they're getting like 250% more healing. Insane. The reason why we're not going to see vampire counts in these battles today is because no one wanted to face my vampire counts. Because they're a little bit busted. As in, they actually don't die. like none of the units die. It's insane. But yeah, I have a video on that. Check out the channel for the shorts. I have a ton of videos and I basically post random tips every day. By the way, Lion Chariots, glorious Lion Chariots, way better than Slaanesh Chariots. They will be annihilating the Khorne Warriors today. Even charging the cavalry, because they do decent damage there. Take a little bit too, but it's fine. And yeah, you have to go back 15 to the beginning. Yeah, 250% extra healing. You know how quickly it takes those... You know how quickly it takes vampire counts to heal cap? 2 minutes. 2 minutes of fighting, and they have reached the maximum amount of healing. Most infantry fights take 3 minutes. Most infantry fights against vampire counts take 5 minutes in Warhammer 2. And now they take infinite minutes because they're not going to die. Well, maybe less because your guy's going to die. 20 USD, Warbird, thank you so much. Saying thank you for all your content in Tissity. I've learned so much about how to play the game and improved since I started watching. Oh my gosh, that's really great to hear, man. Honestly, that's all I really want to do. I want to just grow the multiplayer community. And of course, you know, help out the campaign folks too. By the way, glorious breath attack as we saw on the left side there. Huge damage to the Khorne Warriors. As, yeah, dragons. Dragons are pretty sick. Khorne has nothing on dragons, by the way. Khorne breath attacks with bloodthirsters are measly compared to what the high elves have. It's amazing. Yeah, this is gonna be something. Oh man, the next few days gonna be so good. It's so exciting. I've been, as soon as I got access to this, I won't give you a day, but as soon as I got access to this, I've been itching to show this off for so long. Oh my gosh, this is good. Intensity, did the Lizardmen get any significant buffs? Yes. Tune in for tomorrow when I'm going to tell everybody about how Lord Croak is insane. Absolutely blow your brains busted. Maybe not that strong, but still very good. You guys are going to love it. Lord Croak is just chef's kiss. Chef's kiss good. Sagittarius A. Oh, hey, nice. Some space. With the 5 CHF. I have no idea what that is. CHF is... Congestive heart failure. Well, I don't think that's what currency you gave me, but thank you very much. Yeah, vampire counts, they don't die because they're already dead. Yeah, indeed. Yeah, Lizardmen buffs, they got a little bit of buffs. I think the Salamander hunting packs got piercing. The Razor Dawns can pierce through infantry. Insane damage, it's great. Yeah. Did Gelt get OP or not with Lore of Metal? He's more or less the same. How many unbalanced... miscalculated spells have you found so far? I think like 3 if you count abilities. Mazdamundi's Ruination of Cities is busted. Wolfric's Boat is busted. There's the Dark Elf Power and Darkness, whatever it's called, that gives you 20 wins of magic. There's a little bit. CA know all about it. They're probably gonna have it fixed by the time it launches, but it's great. Dwarf buffs, yes. Rune of Wrath and Ruin does a teensy little bit more damage, and that's it. Other dwarf buffs? Probably not many, sadly, honestly, but what can you do? We advance. We must retire. Grimgor buffs? I haven't checked. I only played... I played one game as the Greenskins, and I think I took Grom instead. Call me... Vanilla. Jeez, I always forget the saying every single time. Devolve? Yeah, Devolve's still broken. Many of you guys already know about that one. Can we see some Vampire Coast matches? I'll see if I can get some in over the next few days. For sure. I'll be getting in more games with the content creators and we'll see what we can do. For now, though, I think we don't have any Vampire Coast. I've gotten a few requests for it, though, so obviously it's in high demand. Hope Nakai got some buffs. Oh, boy. I will say Nakai got a look in that. Nakai got a look in that. You guys should stay tuned for that. You know what? I should take a note. So I don't forget. Nakai. Honestly, I think Lore Master of Sotek's gonna beat me to it. But if he doesn't, I'm totally posting a video on that. Immortal Empires isn't out. It is early access for the partners. We are part of the marketing group, I guess. So we got access to sort of show off some early footage. Though no campaign yet. It's just battles. Yeah, Nakai box. It's amazing. Any changes to the Realm of Souls and Murderous Prowess for Domination? Yeah, Realm of Souls heals way more now. I think in total it heals like 36% HP for Tomb King, so they're celebrating. And then, what's the other one? Murderous Prowess? I didn't check. I feel like it might be the same. Rapunzel? I haven't looked at her. I'll take a look at everything, guys, over the next few weeks for sure. With the 777 USD, by the way, Jonathan Grover, thank you very much. Saying, just wanted to say it's been awesome to see your channel grow over the past several months. It's been amazing, man. Thank you. Thank you. It's great. We're posting videos every single day now. Sagittarius A with another 5CHF, saying that it stands for Swiss Francs Switzerland. Thank you so much for the correction and the second donation. That helps a lot. It is Confortatio Helvetica. Jeez, that is a lot. That's a mouthful. Hey, and look at that. We got the new map. Also, we got a win. Sick. That's win number one against content creators. But yeah, Helvetica is a font, right? But yeah, that's why it's CHF. All right. Sick. Thank you. Thank you very much. But yeah, Tomb King's got a buff. They're healing way more, just like everybody else. Regeneration got a buff. Healing two times more for anyone with a lot of HP. And by the way, today we're playing Norska against the dreaded forces of Cathay. You can see I hovered Wolfric's boat there for a second. Realized it was OP. And I think I told Dov I'm probably not going to cast it because it's a little bit too strong right now. It deletes infantry. Actually one-shots them. It's hilarious. But yeah. Well, it's Norska against Cathay. I got a Fimir build, and he has cannons, which is pretty scary. People are talking about release dates too. I haven't caught it yet, but I'm sure CA, they might have put something out. I don't know. You guys would know better than me. Yeah, we just jumped in here. It is all pre-recorded, sadly, but soon enough we'll get more videos out. No dwarf buffs? Yeah, I'll have to recheck dwarves. But yeah, so for the build today, it's basically a bunch of marauders. You'll notice the spawn points really, really far back. So it's going to take a really long time to reinforce with infantry. But vanguards are super far up. If you take a look right over there, right over there, that reinforcement point is extremely far forwards. I think this is going to be an amazing Slaanesh map and really good for any skirmishers. Like Wood Elves going to love it. For sure, it's gonna be great. Yeah, even the streamer is pre-recorded. Yeah. What if I don't exist? Is this just a deep fake? Who knows? Who knows? Announcing their Q&A. Wonderful, wonderful. I don't have to pretend that I don't know about that anymore. All right, great. Very, very good. Oh, it's your birthday? Nice. Unless you mean it's just because, you know, there's tons of Warhammer news. Now, here's the plan. I'm basically focusing all my forces on the right flank. You'll also notice Domination Games, they reduce the capture unlock points by 1 minute. And that means we just saved 1 minute off of everybody's lives. So the action basically gets started right away. It's great. Absolutely amazing. Reply to this to prove you're not pre-recorded. Well, you know, even if I do say that, what if you're just a bot? I could have just, you know, I could have paid some people to just type in chat, perfectly timed with me responding to it, and then you would never know. You would never know. It's the perfect plan. Anyways, how's this game going? Oh yeah, you'll see in my reinforcements on the bottom, we got some skin wolves. Skin wolves are so good because they regenerate at double speed. It's amazing. What if I'm a bot? I'm pretty sure everybody's a bot at this point. Have you guys seen the speed of technology? It's crazy. Oh man, but yeah, this is a pretty nice collapse. You can see I'm just sort of diving in there, mostly ignoring the cannon so I can kill this infantry. But we're running up against Celestial Dragon Guard, and they're going to be quite scary against me in this fight. Cathay with their huge harmony bonuses, terrifying. In this build, there's no extra 9 bonus melee defense for a formation attack, so thankfully they're not going to be absolutely indestructible. Very good for me. And Tissy, what other wild stuff have you found? I've gone over a ton of things already. But yeah, healing is busted and there's a ton of spells that are busted. I'll go over it, you know, sometime later in the stream. Oh yeah, yo, for any of you guys that are Turin fans, I got some pretty nice games with Turin coming on up. later. It's gonna be great. Yeah, Turin. Yes. Turin's a menace, but... But yeah, I got a pretty nice set. It's... Oh, man. There's a lot of games today, by the way. This is gonna be a longer stream than usual. So for those of you guys that have been starved for content, sick of the Creative Assembly drip feed that is the... Honestly, it's not. It's more of a flowing faucet than a drip feed. The factions every day, amazing. Chaos coming tomorrow. Splendid. Absolutely splendid. But yeah, who isn't a Turin fan, honestly? Well, you know, remember, a lot of people here are sort of very, very campaign-centric. So many of them probably don't know or don't watch as much Turin. Honestly, most of my viewership is like... A lot of them are just Legend of Total War fans, so a little bit of a surprise there. It's like, I'm like sitting in the middle of all these communities. But yeah, honestly, everybody in the community is great. It's just amazing. All right. Oh no, we lost YouTube chat. We lost YouTube chat. Again, I'll open it up on a separate window so I don't have to lose you guys. There we go. Twitch chat, rejoice. You have my full undivided attention for like 5 seconds. All right, there we go. I got YouTube chat back. All hail the mullet, indeed. Indeed. Now, for this actual battle, you can see we did finally push forwards through into the middle. I'm mostly ignoring the far point because it takes a just insanely long time to get there. And we're going to be just sort of holding this position as well as possible. But we are trading down, which is always a bad sign. Domination without the comeback mechanic means if you're trading down, it's much harder to get an easy comeback. It's going to be quite painful. What's it? Zer Pasha saying, honestly, I heard from Turin's channel. And Tisty props to the dreaded man. Oh, what did you hear on Turin's side? You don't play multiplayer and have no interest in starting, but you like watching. Hey, Trey, thank you. Breath attacks come out a lot faster? Oh, I haven't tested. I feel like breath attacks... I don't know, maybe they do? We'll have to see. We'll have to do some testing, but dragons were buffed, which is amazing. Cathay actually doing well in value? I know. For once, look, I'm not gonna call it early. Cathay has always been a rough faction. They've gone a million buffs over the years, and they've just always fallen flat. And by years, I mean months. They've never been meta, and I'm fingers crossed they will actually be playable once we get Immortal Empires out. The Dread Saurians buffer, though? What's this about Dread Saurians? Oh, yeah. Yo, Sigvald is insane. Sigvald is one of those guys that will never, ever, ever die. Also, speaking of Cathay being bad, we just triple capped them. Amazing. Perhaps we'll get a win against Dov here. Though, we are losing Wolfric pretty quickly to those cannons, and I'm sort of running out of infantry, so a little bit worried here. 5,000 years of Cathay history getting buffed. There you go, we got there. And Tisty, do Skavens have any changes? I took a look. Skaven are probably one of the most unchanged factions right now, but their Poison Wind Mortars are looking like they're working. It seems like Creative Assembly got their hands on them pretty early, so overall... They seem about the same as the Warhammer 2 incarnations. Nothing too broken, at least as far as I could find. Did some of the dinos get significant buffs? Yes! Revivification Crystal heals a lot more than it used to. It can heal cap a Dread Saurian in the matter of minutes. It's great. You hope I played as Dowie too? I did! I did! For all of you dwarf fans, we will see dwarves! And by the way, Skinwolf still doing great. They have Vanguard, so they can actually deploy on that very close Vanguard point, and their healing's going to be helping them clean up these scraps of Cathay infantry. Anytime units get really low, these sort of hyper-efficient healing units are the way to go. Man, everybody's spamming the @intisty. The moment you start looking at chat, you give them a foot, and they'll run a mile. I'm butchering all these sayings today, but I don't care. It's an amazing day. All right. Will the dinosaur ball be viable strategy in multiplayer? It depends on if you're talking land battles or... Land battles or domination. Because I think single entity blobbing doesn't really have that high DPS. But look at that! We came back against Cathay. Against all odds, we've actually managed to sort of use our very mobile forces to slowly pick them apart. And it's working pretty well! Which means maybe Cathay's still terrible. Devastating. Absolutely devastating. Poor guys. Maybe one day. One day, but not today. How do the high elves look? Are they... yeah, dragons got almost... they got like 70% more mass. So they can actually push through horses for once. I think the dragons are sitting at like 4,000 or 3,500 mass now. Which is actually comparable to most other single entities. Plus, they got like an extra 1,000 HP or 500 HP. It's really good. Worldbeater saying add into city. Happy to have you here, Worldbeater. Maybe that's what people should do when they join my chat. Just say Adventisty anytime you show up to the chat for the first time. I hope you try out Vampire Balefire Corpse cards. I played a bunch of Vampire Counts games sort of like earlier, but I didn't really get them recorded. And most people now don't really want to play against Vampire Counts. I'll see if I can get that done with Turin though. I'll DM him and we can get some good games going. More Adventicities, happy to have you guys here. Even in chat, too. Yeah, Falcon's gonna be real happy about the dragon changes. I hope he comes back. He's a legendary player. Also, by the way, Cathay, they lost it. How could they have done this? It doesn't matter how many times you buff this faction. They will just always be terrible. But there we go. This is our next win of the day. We're on a 2-winning streak. Very great. And now we get to see... what happens next, man? This chat is like, chat is huge right now. Maybe we shrink this a tiny bit so it's not so in the way. There we go. I'm not used to having so many people talking at the same time. And yeah, you can see Pit of Shades is great. Wolfric, great. I would say Fimir. Actually, they didn't do as well, but Berserkers are pretty fun. Falcon should start a Kickstarter to come back. Ooh, that would get quite a bit. Yeah, Revivification Crystals heal 20% HP per cast. And because it's percentile, it's just a million. Dreadsaurians heal like thousands of HP off one red Rev Crystal. Hey, Colin T, hello. And Tissy, what is 1 plus 1? The streamer math? Streamer math? It's too risky, I won't do it. And Tissy OP, please nerf. Yeah, totally. You know, I fear playing Cathay too, but yeah, we're bringing a classic greenskin build. I wanted to sort of get a feel for how they work out in domination. They do have a lot of cheap units, but they also route really easily, so this could be a bit of a problem. Capture weight being slower, I believe, is in the favor of Nurgle. 1 plus 1 is a number. I'm not going to risk it, though. I'm not going to risk it. Streamers too often screw up math on stream. You know, what if I'm wrong? What if I say 3? You never know. How are the Tomb Kings? Great. I said earlier that they got a buff. It's amazing. And look at that. Grom already on the points. Now, here's the thing. Because the capture points unlock at 2 minutes, you do have to push out as fast as possible. And you're going to be seeing Nurgle suffer a little bit here. Because the points will actually unlock before he gets here if I slow him down. Sad times for Nurgle. I think there's like some weird math equation you can do that technically like breaks the rule of math, but you like get to 1 plus 1 equals 3. There's like some weird chain of equations you can do to make it work. And it's hilarious. There's like what? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 continuous is like negative 1 over 12. Math is weird, guys. Math is really weird. Anyways, enough nerdery. Let's go into the actual game. Grom facing off against Kugath, gets his face slapped, just annihilated. Sorry if that was loud, but he gets totally annihilated. Don't fight Kugath in melee. No one's gonna win that fight. So we disengage and dive in on those Plague Bearers instead, because I want to capture the point. But capturing is actually a little bit slower here, which means Kugath will actually get there as I take the point. On the far side, we have one, and on the other, we have another capture point. And it looks like Dov's gonna be summoning in a couple drones, the Death Head variants. They're gonna be quite scary, and I will be trying to use chariots today, since greenskins historically have had pretty good chariots. Stream of Corruption, devastating, hasn't been nerfed, still does a million damage. Wonderful. Let's see, do we have YouTube chat back over here in Restream? It looks like no, it says error, whatever. Let's see, I'll take a look at Twitch chat for a bit. If you have anything to say on Twitch, let me hear you roar! Anyways, what do we got? You still talking about Falcon? Alright. Cathay needs some new melee attack buffs. Honestly, I'm not sure. Give it a bit of time. It might stabilize where they're good enough. Just because we don't really have a lot of Cathay mains yet. Stream of Wind of Death all day. Oh man, Wind of Death. Yo, Wind of Death got nerfed so hard. Wind of Death got annihilated. It does like less than Burning Head now. It's devastating. Absolutely devastating. Torrent saying we're alive. Nice. Twitch chat has such a different feel from YouTube chat because it's so many emotes. It's fun. Yeah, no, Wind of Death. Look, here's the thing. Everybody knows, all the content creators know that Wind of Death got nerfed. We've all told Creative Assembly that it happened. It should be fixed by Immortal Empires launch. I'm not Creative Assembly though, so if it doesn't get fixed, blame them, not me, alright? But I've let them know. I have let them know. It should be fine. Yeah, Wind of Death getting nerfed, gonna hit Legend bad, yeah. But you know, there's a lot of other lores of magic. I think he'll probably figure out the infinite regeneration type thing and it'll be fine. Legend says Devolve is broken. Yeah, it one-shots infantry. Like, I'm not lying. It actually deletes Graveguard. It takes them from not, like 100 HP, 100% HP to like 2%. It puts them in crumbling. That's how much damage it does. Oh my gosh. Is Norska already playable in multiplayer? Yeah, they're pretty good. Regeneration changes did them some real good work, man. What's a suspicious, Fergalicious, amazing name, saying, hey dude, I'm in awe of your skills in multiplayer. Thank you. Any chance you could pick Lizardmen, please? I think I might have a Lizardmen game. I don't know if it's in here, but I'll play all the other factions once I get my hands on the content creators. Now, we're playing a sort of a classic style here with the green skins. I know that I'm trading down into Nurgle, so the play style is just avoid them. You can see my value is terrible. We're down almost half, plus he has healing. My Grom's almost dead because of the death heads, so it's a little bit scary. But I do have a huge capture point lead, and that's what I'm going to be using. Yeah, Devolve is crazy right now. How's Orc Magic? More or less the same. I think Foot of Gork is more or less the same. Also, by the way, the Wah, look at that icon. I think it's different because I have Grom, but it doesn't actually give different stat boosts, sadly. No, is this a replay? Yeah, this is a replay. We're not allowed to just stream fully just yet, but eventually, you know, we will be able to. But for now, it's just going to be back-to-back battles. Do ethereal units get more health? No, because it's all percentile. So ethereals got hit pretty hard because of the healing changes. But generic mid-tier infantry are so happy. They are so happy because of the healing changes. Check out my recent video on Graveguard. You'll see what I mean. Nurgle has hounds. You have spotted it, good sir. Nurgle actually has some basic warhounds now, indeed. Yeah, it's great. So there's a little bit of sort of faction spreading. Oh, there we go. There's a Foot of Gork. Yeah. The rosters have some interesting things. Like Slaanesh has Sigvald now. It's crazy. Also, Foot of Gork, still amazing spell. Definitely check it out. A tier. Did I get early access? Yeah, this is early access. This is literally me playing in front of you guys right now. Indeed, Sky Guy. How many new units are there? We don't have any access to the DLC. We only have the base game stuff, Immortal Empires. So there aren't any new units yet. Just a bit of sort of shifting around is all. Wait until they get Vanguy's Revenge. Oh, Vanguy's Revenge does a lot of damage. Does a lot of damage. It's great. Did Krokgar get any changes? Not that I could tell. But maybe he got some tweaks, though I didn't really see anything. By the way, one of the main powers of the green skins, losing but technically winning, as all you have to do is just send a million units onto the points and you're more or less fine. Capturing is slightly slower for Immortal Empire, so stealing was a bit harder than I thought it would be, but we still stole it, and Dov now has to try and make that transition. The ever pain of Nurgle, they will just never get to where they want to be fast enough. Gonna play any Vampirates? Not today, but I'll see if I can get that in the next stream. And to see any buffs to Reichsguard? I don't believe so. Greenskins just need to believe that they will win, and they will. Yeah, no, that can be pretty hard. Their leadership is terrible. Also, you'll notice Grom is just amazing here. He is already creeping his way to heal cap, and he's gonna be just a menace to Nurgle. Dov had to commit a ton of death heads to try and kill him. And the fact that he's still alive means that my leadership actually holds together. Have I seen the leaks yet? I've seen the leaks. No comment, though. No comment. That's hilarious, though. Also, Forsaken. Forsaken have, their own icon now, which is great. How's the balancing so far? Balancing is good. Balancing is fairly good, actually. Outside of a few spells that are super busted, nothing has really been too bad, I would say. I could count all of the major issues on both hands. And Creative Assembly knows about it. What are the leaks? Check out Creative Assembly's most recent video. Check it out. Check out their own video, and you'll see it. But for the sake of the people at Creative Assembly's sanity, I'll refrain from talking about that. But actually, check out their own YouTube channel. Check it out while it's hot. Yeah. Yeah, a little bit of DLC business. The battle for the title of greatest green fatso. Yeah, Grom versus Kugath. I think Kugath wins it, though. Grom is constantly running away from that guy because he's a bit too big. How are the Slaan with the magic rework? Pretty good. Mazamundi was great, and Lord Croak is a menace. You'll see a video on that tomorrow. Nice. By the way, this game, very, very close. I almost sort of lost just because of running out of units, but Nurgle's DPS wasn't enough, and on the high ground, I'm pretty comfortable holding that. You can see a huge dog summon trying to shut him down, but it's not going to be enough. We're going to hold that point, and it should be the victory for me in about a minute. Plus, we're also capturing point number 3, so Dov has to commit some units there not to lose that point, which means the high ground should very much well be in my favor. Greenskins running from the middle point. Another foot of Gork missing completely, but it's totally fine. Lizardmen now, please. Yeah, we'll get the Lizardmen eventually. I don't think I have too many games, though. Look, there's a lot of factions. I can't physically play all of them in one day. Which is insane. That's so many factions. Show us goblins. We got a few goblins in here. It's mostly a green big orc boy build, though. What's this about Amogus? What's this about Among Us? Did they increase the respawn time for units? I'm not sure. It might just be because my guys are mortal, so they sort of route off the map and take a really long time to come back. But yeah, Nurgle's gonna lose it. We're gonna capture the bottom point too, because Dov committed really hard on the high ground. And that's gonna be the victory for us in this game too. 3 win streak against Dov, though he did take a game off of me. Intensity. Do you know if Wood Elf AI is able to finally use a travel mechanic? I have no idea. I don't have access to the campaign, sadly. Now, this time I'm playing as Kislev. You might be thinking, Kislev? That's a Warhammer 3 faction. Boring, but it's against Chaos, and it's going to be up against Archaon, and we're going to be playing against HDS, another Warhammer Total War YouTuber. You should check them out if you haven't yet. When is the Dragon Twins wind farming stream? Oh, the Dragon Twins. Wait, the Dragon Twins? What, like Miao Ying and Zhao? There's a lot of dragons in the game, guys. But I'll assume that's what you mean. Cathay versus High Elves wet noodle contest. Ooh, yeah. They're fighting for who's worse. By the way, this is a 5 Streltsy build. For those of you that haven't experienced the Intensity ranged playstyle, this is it. I go a ton of range, I go extremely wide, and we're basically playing American football here. My Zargard are gonna block up these warriors, and every unit that slips through the cracks is gonna get annihilated. By the way, Aspiring Champions got buffed, still terrible, but they got buffed. So that should be quite fun. Is Archaon good now? From what I can tell, he does a million damage, so he's definitely not terrible, which I think is a good sign. And he changes to dwarves. Not yet. Daniel Moore, by the way. Thank you very much for the $5. Saying Intensity. Did you get early access to Immortal Empires? I did, but only to battles. And thank you for the kind words. Happy to hear that my content's doing good for you guys. Now I've been ignoring Twitch real quick. Let's take a quick look. Yeah, not too much. Just people chatting on Twitch. Remember, I am checking both chats at the same time, as well as I humanly can. But yeah, this is going to be going pretty well for me so far in this battle. Also, this is a land battle, which is fun. You can see Archaon does have Purple Sun, but unfortunately, these Vortex spells that move don't really do too much damage. So most of my Streltsy are fine, and we're going to be unleashing a disgusting hail onto these Marauder Horsemen, and they're basically all going to be routing. Very, very painful over there. And it looks like, we just did a pretty good job on blocking up everybody. One of the units of cavalry is going to be diving on through, but shortly, we're just going to be focusing them down with the Streltsy, and it should be a pretty nice tearing apart of this army, I would say. This is a very strong build in land battles, if you can play it right. Essentially, what you do is you take just barely enough melee to keep your ranged units firing all game, and they'll just do insane amounts of damage. Archaon with the Spirit Leech too. You can see it has a nice little hand effect. Does pretty good damage, but my Lord's still at quite high HP. Another true execution. Archaon is good, but Bullet is better. Kazad on YouTube saying, notice me, Senpai, but Twitch. Come on, what? Think about New Eden. We gotta notice the Twitch folks a little bit. There must be a way to combine the chats. I think there's a way you can get Restream to message on both chats, but it sort of looks really, really messy. I'll see what I can do about it. For now, though, I don't know. Maybe open up my YouTube and my Twitch. That's the only way you can do it. Anyways, jokes aside, this match has gone pretty well in my favor. You can see Archaon. He does pretty well. He's a quite tanky fellow. It's not like you can just snipe him. In this case, he was on foot. I was talking to HDS, this was an accident, he meant to take him on his steed, and that's going to be the end of him. There's not too many Chaos Forces left, and in the top left you can see we've got pretty good value, almost twice as much value as HDS, resulting in an army loss. Very, very nice, well played to HDS. On to the next game, it's going to be Slaanesh against High Elves. Now, everybody get ready. Get ready for the comments of, wait, Sigvald is in the Slaanesh roster. You know, feel free to let it out now if you want to. Cathay Wen a couple battles ago. But yes, Sigvald, the bane of all things High Elves, has actually decided that, indeed, he's going to be attacking the High Elves from two different factions now and just absolutely tormenting them. He is still just as good as he was in Warhammer 2. He has insane regeneration. And he does not die. It's going to be amazing. Yeah, Ice Power. Looking pretty happy. Yeah, it's great, man. Did you see Sigvald is in the Warriors roster? Amazing. He's everywhere. He's everywhere, man. And Tissy, so would you agree that High Elves is worse than Cathay? I don't know. I haven't played Cathay into High Elves yet. But honestly, High Elves may still have the lead. Illithanar doing some sneaky strats, by the way, summoning in his clone. We've seen through it, though, and we're not going to attack that, just charging forward. Pretty well, this is a slight landslide. Ah, well, you know. Yeah, the thing about me is that I've been grinding the Warhammer multiplayer scene for so long now. Most content creators mostly focus on making videos, of course, but naturally it means that we do pretty well. We do pretty well in multiplayer. If there's one thing I can be proud in saying I'm good at, multiplayer is one of those things. Those Dragon Princes on the side, by the way, we're sending in our armor-piercing Furies into them, and they're going to be annihilating them. Look at that. That is a 1,700 gold unit. The most expensive High Elf Cavalry you can bring. Trained for hundreds of years, they died in about 10 seconds, though they do get a pretty good Pit of Shades on their way out. Will also kill the Dragon Princes too, but sacrifices must be made. And for the other cavalry on the right flank there, I'm going to be sending in my Furies and doing a bit of cycle charging. In the meantime, my infantry is just shredding the High Elf infantry. None of them are going to trade well here because Marauder Swords have anti-infantry, they're great. And my Exalted Demon Nets, all of them basically at full HP. Just annihilating High Elf infantry. They just destroy everything that they can make contact with. That's going to be a lot of value. Dragon Princess. Oh, my bad. Not 1700. 1400. My bad, Aerocrastic. Ignore that. Ignore that. I was thinking of another cavalry unit. Yeah, I accidentally caused mass panic in the multiplayer scene, because now they think High Elves got nerfed. I accidentally did this earlier today, because the Tyrion's heal ability says it heals 25% HP for 1 second. So I said it only healed 25% of his HP, which had all the elf players just throwing up everywhere. You should have seen the ODM Discord. It was disgusting, but there's a bug. So it actually heals for 2 seconds when it says one. So high elves are basically the same. In fact, it got buffed. Dragons have a bit more mass and a bit more HP now. So rejoice, high elf players. You don't... Now, you can still say high elves are bad. I know all of you guys love being in that field, but they're not as bad now as they used to be. Slight rejoice, but I don't think they're meta. Especially the high elves. They're suffering a little bit now, but you know, it's fine. Hopefully they get more buffs in the future. Alrighty. Endless craving. Might be a silly question. What is ODM? That is a clan that I am in. It stands for Order de Malta. And I don't know what it means. I always forget every time. But yeah, it's just my clan. We have our own Discord where we just chill and talk with each other. And rant about how the elves are weak, mostly. It's a good old time. Yeah, slightly rejoice. Your single entity monsters are a little bit better. Yeah, that's correct. Taking a look at Twitch chat again. High elf players, all two of them. Yeah, Xiphos and Loopy. I can name them. They're there. Yeah, poor Dragon Princess. I can't believe they don't have good armor piercing. It's a sad time. But yeah, this is sort of one of the banes of High Elves. Because Slaanesh infantry are so darn fast, you're never going to run out. You can see the High Elf, all of their infantry have routed, and none of them have actually made it out of the grasp of my Marauders. They just run down infantry so incredibly fast that you just can't kite. And that's one of the only tools that the High Elves have to deal with these sort of rushes. Yes! Attack! The gods demand. Does Slaanesh get access to Warriors of Chaos units too? Not that I've seen. Oh no, yes! Slaanesh gets access to Hellstriders. Guess what? Chaos. Chaos, guys, has 100 speed cavalry now. For those of you guys that hate on Chaos being strong in Warhammer 2, guess what? Yeah, they actually have the fastest cavalry in the game. Rejoice, Chaos players, and now the High Elf players are sad again. We done it. They had their like 10 seconds of happiness, only to hear that every other faction's running faster than them. It's great. What's this about streamer mode? What's going on? Discord sounds? What the? Discord sounds are playing? Discord sounds are playing. Actually, that's really weird. It shouldn't be. It really shouldn't be. Weird. What Discord sounds are playing? Is it like a lot of Discord sounds? No, someone in chat let me know. You haven't heard any Discord sounds? Okay, it's just Twitch then. Dang it, Twitch. Why you gotta throw me off? Alright, YouTube chat's got my back. Twitch is insane, apparently. Come on, 05906. What are you doing? Anyways, how's this game going? Ah, yes, wonderfully. You can see Slaanesh is trading up amazingly. Sigvald has healed too, which means most of that damage is actually moot. And we also have a speed buff. Alithanar is running for his darn life, but we're gonna net him down and get the demonettes on top of him. That's gonna be a very rough time for Alithanar. My marauders are everywhere. They're basically cavalry, except infantry. It's amazing. And Alithanar gets charged by the demonettes. You'll see his HP. Suddenly, just 25% of it is gone. Demonettes are amazing, guys. Yeah, if you can actually keep them alive, it's gonna be really painful. Alithanar. Now trying to run for his life. An even worse idea, because his back is now turned and demonettes are substantially faster than him. He's all of a sudden at half HP. You can see his shadows just trailing behind, just running, trying to distract the demonettes. They don't care. And he is suffering right now. It is glorious. If you want a fast faction that'll never get kited, Slaanesh. It's great. Play Beastmen and use Devolve. Well, look, see, this is against content creators. We don't want to be, you know, just whipping out the most OP abilities against them. So we're taking it pretty easy. Now you get to play Slaanesh with Sigvald and not get air cheese by taking more Auto Horsemen. I know. Chaos is the new Slaanesh. It's great. Are there any units in Slaanesh roster that you think is underutilized? Not less utilized than they should be. Like, Slaanesh Chariots are pretty weak, so you don't see them too often. Yeah, Sigvald is now on the Slaanesh roster. He's also on the Warriors of Chaos roster, too, so he's double-dipping, as the Sigvald is wont to do. Your content creators, they're here to get run over by me. And my obsession with Warhammer multiplayer. Now, Malkoth's Miasma will be finishing off my Demonettes. He did actually kill off the Demonettes, as they are quite squishy. But his army is in tatters at this point. Sigvald is at 100% HP. And I'm pretty sure I could AFK and Sigvald would win it. Yeah, double dipping. Can't wait for the Sigvald mirror match. Slaanesh Sigvald against Chaos Sigvald? Sligvald? Ugh. Anyways, yeah. Slaanesh Sigvald against Chaos Sigvald. It's gonna be great. Intisti, you should feel bad for that pun. I really should. I'm not even sure exactly which pun you're talking about, but I feel bad about each and every single one of them. Is there a possibility to see some Skaven matches? Not today, but probably in the coming days. I'm gonna schedule some more games against content creators, and we're just gonna be grinding out content for you guys. I'm sure every single content creator in the partner program is just gonna be spamming you guys with videos every day until Immortal Empires comes out, because this is far too exciting. Who's harder to kill, Sigvald or Gorok? I would put my money on, I put my money on Sigvald. Gorok does more damage, but Sigvald, I think he's harder to kill on account of that insane regeneration. Jorn, that's a little bit rude. Come on, you gotta play it out for the contest. That's a pretty good Pit of Shades too. He does catch some infantry, and he does still have his caster, but army losses kicks in, and that's gonna be another win. 5 wins today, guys. 5 wins. Dov is the only guy that managed to, wait, did army losses kick in yet? It didn't, but this is still a win. We do get some games in against Turin, though, and he is a much more renowned multiplayer guy. Later today, so stay tuned. Stay tuned for that. Take more damage, yeah. Alright, now for the next game, it's going to be against Lore Master of Sotek. And for this game, I brought a bit of a meme build. It's going to be the Dwarves with a full Slayer stack to start, and a ton of guys in a ton of infantry in reserve, some Vanguard to take advantage of that Vanguard point, and Lore Master of Sotek has gone for the legendary Invisible Army. If you guys don't know, he's playing Lizardman in the top left, so it should be an interesting battle. The dreaded meme build, yeah. I'm hoping that he has a lot of monsters that we can try and run down here. But yeah, here we go, the first Dwarf game of today. Hopefully they do well. Fingers crossed. Will Slaanesh get any DLC? On unit models. We can all hope for it, but unfortunately the ratings will probably do us in. Maybe with the blood DLC, you know? If the blood DLC is all about ratings, maybe that's the strat, right? Just make like an R-rated DLC. R-rated Slaanesh DLC. Yeah, kill anything without a beard indeed.
Obey me!
Yeah, now let's see, what's going on Twitch chat? What's it? You like the vids? Hey, thank you very much, Garlic. Talking about the Sigvald versus Gorok matchup. Yeah, I would say Sigvald's just a menace. So he actually got some changes to his abilities that make him pretty strong. Now, unfortunately, we did run into a pretty rough situation here, where it is mostly skinks and the dreaded Gorok on foot. Now, Gorok, he's no Sigvald, but he's still a pretty nasty legendary lord. We're going to be seeing if we can take him out, though. I do have two characters that are very heroic, between Gotrek and Ungrim. He should be having at least a decently hard time, fingers crossed. Hey, nice, we finally have YouTube chat back on my main screen. Wonderful. Wonderful, happy to have you here, guys. Yeah, today's going pretty well, man. Yeah, Slayers,
Keep it coming.
Yeah, give it to the Slayers. That's right, Luce. That's right.
Yes.
Now, for now, I'm mostly worried about the Skinks. You can see I've been summoning in a ton of range, but now I have to summon in some infantry, as basically I don't have too many other units to summon. And this is one of the main problems with dwarves. They generally don't have a lot of mobility to get into the fight very fast. Be trying to make the best out of it though. I sort of sense a little bit of weakness here in the lines of Lore Master of Sotek. It seems like he doesn't have his full army here potentially, so I'm going to be trying to take an early engagement to try and just army wipe him essentially. He summoned some Skinks, so I respond with some minor blasting charges, and now the fight begins. I'm reckoning that Gotrek plus Ungrim should be able to kill Gorok because he is outnumbered there, and the fight begins. So the Slayers are just charging straight into those Skinks. I think I botched one of those charges there, unfortunately. Still though, fairly decent damage on both sides. And against those Orowar Croxagores, I should be able to fight them pretty well with my Lords. So they're just diving in. For the Pterodon Riders, they get a nasty rock drop though. Really nice play to shut down my range for Sotek. And they're going to be a little bit of a pain here as most of my range is sort of disrupted. Blasting charges cover the right flank. And now, it depends on how well the middle goes. And honestly, if you take a look at the top left, trading is going slightly in the favor of Lore Master of Sotek. Things are looking a little bit scary here as we are trading down slightly and I don't have too much healing. Though, I do still have my two Lords. They are shredding apart those poor, poor ancient Croxagores. But the front line, despite me technically winning it, my infantry is way more expensive and they're just taking tons of damage. Will Kislev get access to Gotrek and Felix? I haven't checked, but I don't think they have them in their pool just yet. Nurgle Mortis engine? Oh yeah, that Nurgle Mortis engine is actually insane. It does so much damage. But yeah, Gotrek's going to be a pretty nasty hero against anything large. As for the frontline fight, you can see I actually did lose against the Saurus Warriors. Saurus do trade up into Slayers, and it's going to be a little bit scary for capture points. I only have 1 point. So I would say I'm decently far behind here, but not so far behind that we can't win it. I sense the play that I need to make to get a comeback. And now, executing it, my Gotrek and Ungrim are going to be diving in on Gorok. The plan is to go for an assassination mission, as he is alone right now. And if I can kill him and trade up well enough, that should be enough of a lead for me to win, as many of his guys should just rout off fairly easily, and then I can just keep reinforcing with my infantry to capture the points. Fingers crossed that's the plan anyways. Yeah, Dwarven Cannon would have been pretty good here with how big the map is. I wanted to test out a full infantry build, though, just to feel the suffering a little bit. Over here, you can see the fight has started between Gotrek and Gorok, and I feel like I have enough of a lead, if I can snipe him out, where I can start capturing that far point. So summon the Longbeards on the left side, and the fighting continues, but if we take a look at the HP, you can see it's actually not that good. I've done about a third damage to Gorok, but somehow he's done a third damage to Ungrim and Gotrek at the same time. And that's pretty scary for me now as I sort of reevaluate the situation. The HP on Gotrek rapidly decreasing. And now I'm a little bit worried. Gorok is a beast of a lord. You can see, despite getting two of the strongest Slayers in the world, he manages to take them apart. Gotrek even gets his heal to proc, but dies in the process, and now it's just Ungrim. It's a half HP Ungrim against Gorok. Not impossible for him to win, but pretty sketchy, and in fact, Lore Master of Sotek now going for the triple cap. It's pretty scary. Do you like the new devolve? The new devolve is disgusting, Loopy, and you know it. But yeah. And now Ungrim down to 1/4 HP, Gorok just tearing him apart. He has the infantry support, and now things are looking pretty dire. Pretty dire overall, as now that capture point is stolen. Yeah, everything with the beard was slain today. Why is the camera so jumpy? It's because when I select my reinforcement points, it sort of snaps it across. It's just a thing with with Warhammer's camera system. And also because I'm playing multiplayer, I move my camera a lot. I tried to keep it pretty low for people watching, but sometimes it will jump pretty hard. Will you show off dragons next? I did earlier in the stream, so if you check out the VOD, you should be able to see it. But this is pretty rough for me. I might steal that far point, but all of my range is shut down. That's my only potential for coming back here. And Loremaster of Sotek is looking to win it, though trading is still fairly even. So potentially there's a chance of a comeback if I can come back like 2,500 points. But range units are definitely going to have to hard carry for that to happen. Yeah, the full Slayer looks like it doesn't work. You'll probably have to go for a much more heavy ranged build and hopefully hold your ground. Cannons should be pretty good too, as they are extremely well defended. But that's basically everything that's in the Dwarven Jewel Belt. They're basically Cathay, but worse. And that puts you in High Elf territory. That's not a comfortable place to be at all. What factions am I going to play next? Well, you'll see in just a moment, as soon as we finish up this game. The Great Shaving. Devastating. At least Lizard Men aren't an evil faction. I don't think they would shave dwarves. But yeah, I was really surprised that Gorok just 1v2'd the two strongest slayers in the world casually. Devastating. Devastating. We'll need an Ungrim buff, I think. You think it one-shots Khorne Warriors? Yeah, Devolve would one-shot Khorne Warriors. Though, because of how the marks now work, Khorne Warriors have 15% magic resist. Rejoice! Champions of Khorne, you can finally resist spells a tiny little bit better. So they're actually pretty happy. I believe Halberds got a melee defense buff, so they are super strong right now. Khorne Halberds and Chaos Halberds are extremely difficult to kill. And I would also say, overall Chaos factions are pretty happy. They got a lot of changes that are helping them out, but that's a loss. That's a loss for us, as Loremaster of Sotek actually takes the win. Let's see if we can get our revenge though, as now we're playing as Empire with a little bit more of a standard build. We're going with the light memes with the Gelt, but otherwise this is pretty meta, I would say. And for Sotek, Archaon, the Everchosen, with his new and shiny model, look at that. He is huge now. Compared to the spawn, he's actually taller than them. He has a huge spell kit, and there we go, we did get to see a few of his spells. Very, very interesting changes to Archaon. I hope he becomes meta, as he is sort of the representative of Chaos. And we'll see how this goes. I brought myself some Huntsmen, and Gelt has brought a Plague of Rust. You can see the icon has changed. A lot of the spells have sort of gone a quick little touch-up, so they look a little bit different, and some of them play a bit different. Final Transmutation 2 looks amazing. There's like tons of VFX that goes on when you cast it. So hopefully we get to see that this game. Durgar, Pony of the Apocalypse, no more, indeed. No, it's menacing, man. And for my reinforcements, this is a great thing about Empire. They can reinforce pretty well with cavalry, so they're not too worried about this map being extremely big. You'll also notice the cavalry in the distance. I believe that is Khorne cavalry. I believe that Skull Crusher is on the Chaos roster, so pretty scary, I would say. And hopefully they don't run over my extreme lack of armor piercing. You mad with hype? It's so exciting, man. Immortal Empires, I will say, the state of multiplayer is actually pretty good, considering that we are still quite a ways away off from launch. I would say general unit and faction balance, if they just touch up a few other places, it's pretty good. It's pretty good. Now, obviously, multiplayer players, give it a couple months and they'll find, like, the meta will settle and they'll hate it. But in general, I would say it's pretty nice. Now, obviously, I'm biased towards Warhammer as a whole. Also, as a person, I'm generally an optimist. So take my optimism with a grain of salt if you're generally more pessimistic. I'm sure you'll find something to hate when Immortal Empires launches. But as it stands right now, at least the battles are looking pretty fun. Lots of changes. I love the magic changes. And now for the battles to go underway. We are seeing I am advancing pretty aggressively. I want to get the fight started early to get my Huntsman shooting. before that Hell Cannon does too much damage. You already hate playing against Kislev. There you go. That's the spirit. You hate how weak Cathay is? Nice. I'm liking that energy too. Honestly, you know, maybe... The thing is, if they give Formation Attack a +9 melee defense boost, maybe that makes Cathay OP. But I feel like I've said that about 10 times now for different changes, and they've never been remotely close to OP, so we'll probably be fine. Except for people that play Land Battle. You'll notice Burning Head. Wait a second, did that Burning Head just take 3/4 HP off Flagellant? Does that mean Burning Head was buffed? Yes! Yes, it was! Guys, Burning Head, I would like to finally tell you guys that it has indeed been buffed. Burning Head is now roughly equal to strength as Penumbral Pendulum in terms of its overall damage. It's very good. Would highly recommend using it, except for the fact that Pit of Shades is just a better spell. But otherwise, Burning Head is looking pretty good now by all intents and purposes. Creative Assembly actually looking at these older spells and balancing them out as they were meant to be. It gives me high hopes that we will actually get a fairly stable launch. Pretty excited. You will also see now Chaos, the ultimate bringers of doom. They are summoning in Slaanesh Cavalry now to chase down my Demogryph Knights. I'm terrified, so I disengage. Bring in some Halberds to try and block them, but they're going to be murdering my Pistoliers. If you didn't notice, my Pistoliers, they have 95 speed to the 100 speed of the Slaanesh Cavalry. So I basically have to engage into melee with them to shut them down. Another huge Burning Head. Insane damage, going to be terrifying. And I think we've lost YouTube chat again. So let me just open that up on a monitor. There we go, we got you guys. I'm seeing you guys again. Intensity, how good are Lizardmen, any standout performers so far? Yeah, Razordon Hunting Packs have the same thing that the Crane Gunners have. They pierce units. Healing on the Revivification Crystal is insane. It heals 20% per cast, which means a Dreadsaurian heals over 2,000 HP off of one cast, which is huge. And Lizardmen, they also have... Oh, there was something else. There was something else for the Lizardmen that was good for them. Ah, yes, Lord Croak is a menace. Lord Croak is a menace, because his damage for his spells is basically the same as his Warhammer 2 incarnation. Which is to say that they weren't nerfed. Every other spell got nerfed in the transition, so that makes Lord Croak pretty scary. What unit has been surprisingly effective? Honestly, everybody's been performing about as well as you would expect them to between Warhammer 2 and 3. So I would say no huge standout folks, but in general, we're seeing a lot of interesting legendary lords show up, which is great. Yeah, the Toad. Nah, Croak is amazing. He is scary and very cheap too in multiplayer. I will say for people that play campaign, you'll love him. You'll love Lord Croak. He hasn't changed a single bit since Immortal Empires. Yeah, Final Transmutation is pretty good. It did nice damage, but nothing like mind-blowing. Still pretty good. Warhammer Total War. Jesus, Optimus Prime. Jeez. He's back with the puns. Now, that's going to be a pretty good Final Transmutation. You can see we are trading actually slightly below even right now. And we actually don't have the capture points, so a little bit scary again against Lore Master of Sotek. But we're definitely not far behind a comeback. As you can see, Cavalry can now capture points slightly faster, so we're taking that far point. And potentially, since I have quite a lot of forces nearby, I might be able to start trading up here. I'll need to take some very good engagements, but look at that. We get an overcast Plague of Rust. Those guys... Well, they're only Marauders, so I totally misplayed there. But they're going to get annihilated by my Huntsmen. So joke's on them. But what I really wanted to cast it on was those Chosen in the distance and those Chaos Warriors. And the fact that I cast Plague of Rust on Marauders is going to be hurting me a little bit. Thankfully, we will be capturing some points now. And this means even if I'm trading down a bit, as long as I can hold, we should be fine. Yeah, Lore Master of Sotek actually doing pretty good. He's bringing some nice compositions. He's making, like, taking fairly nice engagements. Honestly, not a terrible player. Though right now, I will say, it looks like we are taking a slight lead now. I've taken the lead in terms of the overall map control, but we're still trading down. Specifically though, I do see a little bit of blood in the water. Archaon getting a little bit overzealous, focused down by Huntsman a tiny bit, and now focused by my Pistoliers. We land Gelt, but a bit of a feint. We're going to be dancing him around on the capture point and getting as much focus fire as humanly possible. I'm keeping an eye on the Plague of Rust too. And if we can get a Plague of Rust and a Focus Fire on him, he should die, and that might be able to give us the value that we're looking for. And there we go, Plague of Rust is back off cooldown. It's on Archaon. I'm rapidly moving my Pistoliers into position. And can we snipe him out is the big question. Yeah, no, we're getting a lot of views. It's crazy, man. It's crazy. Bonkers, even. Camera giving me nosebleeds. You know. Unfortunately, I do jump around a lot, but there you go. Archaon getting blasted by the Pistoliers. He's going down very quickly, and now it's a pretty good position for me. The snipe alone on Archaon almost caught us back up in value. We've stolen the middle point, and now I would say we have a lead. You're very happy for me, eh? Thank you. Yeah, no, it's very exciting. By the way, guys, for people who haven't seen this stream before, I'm a multiplayer guy. If you want to see me crush it on ladder and multiplayer, this is the place to be. I stream at around this time. It's generally a good time. We sort of just chill, relax, positive attitude, and yeah, that's basically it. And Rip faces off on multiplayer. I also occasionally play campaign, so yeah, I do want to advertise the stream a little bit, but most of the people here I do recognize, so we don't gotta go over that too much. As for the actual battle, Sotek is now starting to summon in dogs to try and secure points, but I think we've established enough of a mobility lead where I should be able to trade pretty well into those dogs. So, aside from that single unit of Chaos Halberds that I have no chance of killing, I'd say things are pretty good. In fact, because Archaon was chased off the map by Gelt, the leadership of Chaos should start faltering, and generally, Chaos is not a super high leadership faction. If you do kill off their legendary lord, or their lords in general, the rest of the units tend to fall apart. Yeah, we happily destroy people on multiplayer in the best way imaginable. And there we go, the dogs are routed off. We do a big collapse in on those Chaos Warriors. Plague of Rust is an amazing spell. I would say probably underrated for the campaign community, but even in campaign, if you just want something to have good armor piercing early on, a metal caster is the way to go. Though there's only one metal caster in the Empire roster, so I guess you have to be playing Gelt for that. But regardless, we're looking pretty good. He did capture that far point, which is giving him victory tickets, but because I have a lead in tickets, I'm not too worried about that, and instead I can focus on defending the two that I already control. Yeah, Arborist, insane viewership, it's crazy. And Milk and Cookies in chat too, for anyone who wants to catch some very cinematic Warhammer content. For anyone who's throwing up by my extremely fast camera movement, if you want to see more cinematic battles and just general sort of news type content, Milk and Cookies is very on point for that. Definitely check him out. Wonderful channel for Warhammer. And yeah, he's bringing up the Devolve being absolutely broken. There's no way there's no way CA doesn't fix the Devolve problem. There's just no way. Like, it literally one-shots units for 4 wins of magic. If they didn't fix that, it'd be hilarious, but like, we've notified them. Turin next? Turin soon! Turin very soon. I got a good number of games against them. I'm so excited to show them off. But yeah, look at that. Value trading is up. We're up in capture points. We were actually behind early on in this match against Lore Master of Sotek, but we barely scrapped it back together. And that's going to be a nice victory for us. Very good. Nice win streak going so far. We have 7 wins to 2 losses. We had 1 loss a little bit earlier, so not the longest win streaks, but still pretty good win ratio. Conditions creative acceptable. Assembly quick fixing, that's a surprise. Well, we'll see. We'll hold off our bets until we actually see it, right? You never know. There's always a chance they say they fix it and it's not fixed. That there's a multitude of ways this can go wrong, so I'm just sort of hedging my bets that it'll be good. I know, almost 1k viewers if you include Twitch chat. Hello Twitch chat, by the way. Yeah, It's insane. This is actually, this broke my personal best viewership by over double. That's almost an increase equal to how much the vampire count's healing got buffed. Isn't that insane? If I had to choose to either get the viewership bump that I did, or get a similar bump equal to how much the vampire counts got buffed, I would choose the vampire count. I can't believe their healing makes their units indestructible. What even happened? I don't know. Creative Assembly just... the percentile healing, I have no idea. Like, I think it's hilarious. I'm not actually upset about it. But the amount of healing increase they got is so much. It's so much. It's bonkers. Yeah, it's... I don't know. I don't know. But, you know, what can you do? What can you do? Yeah, real viewer. Number 103 reporting in. Yep. Let's see. I cannot read your name. It's like a dark brown, and I can't separate it. But I think it says the meat something. I don't know. But anyways, we're up against, let's see, Lord of Supply Block. I believe that's Turin, guys. Here we go. We're up against the man, the myth, the legend himself. Turin coming on in with the Dark Elves up against Lanesh. I'm running Sigvald. Who wouldn't run Sigvald? He's running Marathi, and he is running a very interesting spell combo. It's going to be Soul Stealer plus Power and Darkness. For those of you guys that haven't, yeah, it's Turin. It's Turin. You guys know. Anyways, he brought the Power and Darkness, which does a little bit of damage, tickles your infantry a little bit, and it gives you 20 winds of magic. Which means, essentially, he's going to have infinite Soul Stealers here. Going for the tryhard build, but, you know, I'm bringing Sigvald. We're both tryharding here. I even bought a cultist, the ultimate tryhard, his least favorite unit in the entire game. We're just trying to make each other suffer as much as possible, as was destined. And I've brought a really nasty infantry build here. I know Dark Elf infantry, each and every single one of them, is going to die to my exalted demonettes like no tomorrow. So I'm happy to run those guys straight into his forces, but he brought the dreaded Cold One Chariots. These guys are insane against infantry, and if they do get a solid charge, they're gonna get murdered. Yeah, this is a very thematic fight, it's true. Yeah, he bought the ultimate power build. That's right, Atherion. Yeah, indeed, and it's gonna be pretty scary. You know, honestly, if he doesn't release that video and have ultimate power in the title, I think we riot, because... there's no way Turin doesn't do that. And here we go. The battle begins. Chariots slam right into my Marauders. Thankfully, they're fairly cheap, so I'm not too worried about that loss. Slams into my other Marauders. Now it's getting a bit expensive. I'm hurting a tiny bit on account of not having my cavalry into position. And that's a pretty nice lead for Turin, securing about 500 gold value. He has cavalry in the distance, and I'm sweating a little bit at this point. But we're not over just yet, as my cavalry... slam into his chariots. They are anti-large. His chariots don't do that much, don't have that much armor. So look at that, instantly shredded. Now he does get a soul stealer, does pretty nice damage, but less than you would think. And a huge pendulum on his cavalry. Half HP suddenly gone on his very, very elite cavalry. And I pull up in lead in value, though it's extremely close, neck and neck. Now he's in the lead. And now I'm gonna be in the lead as my cavalry countercharge. Still though, very scary, but I still have my ace in the hole, the very elite exalted demonette. And lucky for me, he just summoned in two units of spears to get thrown into the meat grinder. Very excited for that. Loopy saying, looks like the games, looks like they're bugged out and do no damage. Oh, that's unfortunate. But yeah, overall, it looks like we have routed off his cavalry. I've pulled up a pretty solid lead, but he's done pretty nice damage to my heroes. The cultist is already at half HP, and my hero that I brought, I don't know why I brought that hero. Oh, she's my caster, because I have Sigvald. Amazing. Yeah, I forgot, you don't have to have a caster lord anymore as Slaanesh. That's amazing. Anyways, she's going to be doing great, as long as she doesn't get sniped out by Marathi. The spears are running for their lives. Not fast enough, though, as demonettes are just far too scary. And then I can throw down another pendulum to just route off those marauders. I want them done and out of there as soon as possible so that I can keep pushing into his back lines to disrupt his any ranged play that he decides to go for. And very nicely for him, you can see in the distance there, he has the Blades of the Blood Queen? No. Whatever the ROR spheres are, which is a pretty big gold value loss for Turin, as I've been focusing all in on this middle lane over here. Yeah, no, Turin's video with the unlimited power, it's totally gonna drop. He's gonna do a better casting job than me here, so still check it out for sure, because I think it's gonna be great. But yeah, it's looking pretty good now, as even though he does have infinite Winds of Magic, I think, I believe on this build, Soul Stealer is actually quite nerfed. It does a lot less damage than it did before, so he's sort of being a bit inefficient with his spell casting, but he does actually snipe out my Lord, and that's gonna be, or my hero. I keep thinking my caster's my Lord. I'm not used to having Sigvald yet, but she does snipe out my caster, so no more magic for me. Thankfully, I've spent most of it, and now Marathi is surrounded by a lot of mobility. And this is why Slaanesh is great on this map too. You can see I just take a quick look at what cavalry he has, and just instantly summon the counter, and they're there in seconds. So it's really hard to try and back cap Slaanesh, and that should be a pretty nice punish for me. As for Marathi, she's getting terrible things done to her by the forces of Slaanesh. Now Sigvald realizes that Marathi is in there, and this is why everybody posts so many things about Warhammer and R-rated content in general. Yeah, we're just gonna ignore that. Honestly, I feel like I should censor it with something, because Sigvald is beelining it towards it. It couldn't be a worse setup. Oh my gosh, she's gonna get. Oh no, I'm gonna net her. Oh no, oh jeez. Marathi's gonna get netted down, surrounded by demons, and Sigvald on top. I don't know how much worse it can get. Yeah, well, there you go. And there we go, it's gonna drop. I'm considering it too. I wonder if I even have to. And oh my gosh, there we go. Yep, I commit to it. The net is down. Sigvald is in there. He blocks her HP with his portrait. It's all Sigvald. Terrible. In the back, his cavalry's routing. And Turin, knowing that I might get demonetized. Oh, right. What is that? Was that Wind 7? I think that was Wind 7, if I'm not mistaken. Boom. This is another game against Turin on the very heavily forested map against his Wood Elves. Now, like I said, Tomb Kings got buffed. They now heal 36% HP on their passives proccing, which is amazing. Really, really good for them. Sorry, just checking something. There we go. All right, nice. We're back. So yeah, this is going to be Tomb Kings against Wood Elves. Historically bad for Wood Elves because of Ushabti. But for those of you that don't know, Wood Elves get a whole host of huge combat buffs when they're fighting in the forest. And that is exactly what Turin is going to be doing today. No Realm of Souls, as there's too much forest cover. I basically don't have any ranged advantage here, so I'm definitely not going for that. And he has a bunch of, I believe those are War Dancers. Yeah, War Dancers, sending them in. I'm gonna summon a Skeleton Summon to see how much damage I can do. But overall, it looks like they're gonna be trading pretty well. Yeah, 36% HP total. Tomb Kings get halfway up to heal cap, but the problem is that the healing procs tend to happen when many of your units are still at full HP. So it actually doesn't heal as much as you would think. I initially thought it was OP, but the more I play around with it, the more I feel like it's actually not too bad. But yeah, in campaign though, Tomb Kings are really happy about the passive buff. Slaanesh Cavalry may be a bit too cost effective, we'll see. A lot of people sort of worried about Warhammer 3 factions once Immortal Empires came out. And honestly, I feel like Warhammer 3 factions are maybe even a bit stronger than the Warhammer 2 factions, if not equal, as their units are very cost efficient, so generally they can stand their ground in many, many cases. Though we'll see as the meta develops. Turin 2 also has huge amounts of easy summons that you can throw onto the points, and this is going to be really nice for capturing. Thankfully, I do have my infantry getting on over there, so they should be able to steal that point soon enough, at least away from the Wild Riders. How much was the old heal? I think it was like half or less. So like Tomb Kings would only heal like 10 to 15% in the best case scenario. Now it's a lot more chunky, and you can see me hovering the ability now. 0.4 seconds for 21 seconds. That's basically like your entire army gets like half or a full invocation of Nahek on that third tier, which is pretty good. Summon units shouldn't be able to cap. Bubba's Big Blast, I got news for you. They haven't been able to cap since forever. Unless you're responding to some comment where someone says that they should. But since launch, they haven't been able to. So no worries there. You're totally fine. Now for me, I'm playing outside of the woods. I'm just terrified of the wood elves. And we don't want to get overrun by them in the forest. That's like the perfect playground. Instead, we'll fight them in the open. Put a couple archers in the forest for safety and see if we can take some efficient fights here. You thought I said they could? Yeah, sometimes I misspeak, sometimes I'm not super clear, but it's all good, man, it's all good. Now for the actual battle, generally what the Tomb Kings have here is their infantry will never ever die. They'll die a bit faster than the vampire counts, but overall they're quite tanky and they generally trade up, especially against the low armor of the Wood Elves. This is why the matchup was bad back in Warhammer 2, but in Warhammer 3, all this terrain, all this forest, the easy vanguard points do make things a little bit spicier. You can see my chariot's getting blocked up by the Treekin. Very nice play from Turin to make sure that I can't run over his infantry. Zypher, hello, happy to have you in chat. And over on the far flank, he's putting a lot of pressure too. Thankfully, we're not really getting overwhelmed on either side, and Durthu is sort of content sitting in the forest in the middle. So, as long as he doesn't get stuck in a fight, we should be good. Because honestly, right now, I don't have too many tools to really shut him down just yet. Talking about Turin's reinforcement summons. Oh, maybe that. Yeah, map looks pretty good for Wood Elves, but honestly, I'm not entirely sure. It's a little bit awkward on some fronts, but we'll see. It depends on how well the middle defends you from Waywatcher fire. I think that's sort of the biggest thing. In the meantime, on the right side, I'm reinforcing equal to what Turin is doing to sort of constantly lock him down. And over here, we're casting Fate of Yuna. It's actually a fairly strong spell. It's just a little bit expensive, which makes it rough. And I think I actually canceled it since those War Dancers are getting run down by my chariots. Massive damage over there. Amazing for me. Enticity, wasn't the number of entities for Dowie Gyrocopters increased? Indeed, yeah. It's up to, what? Well, it should only be up to 4 now, because it's Ultra, right? It's not like they're at 12 models. Unless they are, in which case that would be huge. I didn't actually take a look at it, though, but maybe after the stream. As for the middle, Durthu has finally evacuated to try and help the fight on point number 3. But if you couldn't tell by where my camera is looking, I don't really care about point number 3. I've noticed Turin has sort of been summoning a ton of units there, so I'm just going to start committing into the middle to focus my forces where he's weakest and stall where he is the strongest. Generally a pretty good strat. Undead factions play the style very well, and you can see he's barely capturing that point. It's a struggle, and in the meantime I can easily capture the middle due to my repositioning. So pretty good play for me. I cancel the Fate of Yuna there. I'm sort of considering if I want to route those guys off. Maybe I do it, maybe I don't. Maybe I route off these War Dancers. Yes, I do. And Fate of Yuna generally takes off about half of their HP. So those guys should more or less be dead. Multiple Ushabti summons. Yeah, I have melee Ushabti, because they'll capture points way faster than the ranged guys on account of actually fighting on the point. One of the things you're most hyped for is the return of the memes, like Optimus Prime and Hellebron James. Yeah, honestly, the memes are pretty good. The memes are pretty good. And one of the most enjoyable things about reading chat. On Twitch, they're saying Nagash was weak, Cetra rules, of course. Though I am running Ark in the Black, so we're not running Cetra. Maybe that statement is a little bit incorrect. But Ark in the Black, he's doing pretty good. Yeah, Ark in the Black, I don't think he'll ever be off meta. He has just such great utility, even if he does get nerfed. Nothing else really provides what he does on the Tomb Kings roster. So he'll be pretty good for a while. Over on the far point, you can see the pain of the Wood Elves. Just not enough DPS to clear my infantry. They still don't have that capture point. And now Turin's sweating a little bit. I've traded up by focusing and stealing, killing all of his units in the middle. And now he has quite a bit of space to come back. Durthu, still a very strong unit. If he does get there, he should be able to support and win the fight. But we don't know if Turin's going to be able to do it fast enough. As many of you guys know, trees generally pretty slow, so that could be pretty rough. Has Anticity always been double streaming? No, pretty recently we've started double streaming, but yeah, it's been quite the recent affair. Many people claim Nagash is weak, but Manfred never shuts up about it. Indeed, Ivan. Yeah, Manfred, he's a bit too focused on that, I would say. I feel like he should focus on his own life goals rather than trying to surpass others. I don't know. I gotta say though, Manfred, probably the most hateable guy in all of Warhammer. As the guy that literally ended the old world in some canons of lore that we will not humor. Yeah, I gotta say, many people not fans of Manfred. I think we're happy to see that he was finally kicked out of... why am I thinking Castlevania? You know what? Whatever. Manfred was kicked out of Castlevania, so we won't have to deal with him anymore in the Empire, and hopefully he just gets slaughtered in the Thunderdome. Fingers crossed. And to see, how can you have life goals when you're not living? I guess I can't argue with that, can I? The artillery dude will be good versus Nurgle. Oh, Ka-Tap? DJ Ka-Tap? Yeah. Yeah, no, he'll be pretty cool. He has some nice damage. I would say, I don't know how well he'll do against Nurgle, but I'm happy to test it out eventually. End Times isn't my canon. For many people, it isn't, for sure. But yeah, it looks like Tomb Kings have won it, against all odds. Many people theorize that this would be a good map for Wood Elves. I was a little bit skeptical, and it seems like in their bad matchups, despite there being a fairly large forest, Wood Elf melee builds don't really seem to have what it takes to take out these types of armies. They generally, you know, forests are basically only a 20% buff, and 20% won't make back being behind, you know, 100% or 50%. So while it might be good for some people, I'm sure Xyphos could easily win any game as Wood Elves on any map. But for the majority of you guys, I would say probably it'll still be a bit of a scrap. You definitely want better matchups. Does Arkhan's faction get vampire counts units? I don't think they do. They might be stuck in like the campaign exclusive category, so. Yeah, so not that I know of, sadly. With so many Tomb Kings around him, getting slaughtered by Scarbrand, his raised dead pile will be massive. Oh, that's true, yeah. Yeah, you abuse Scarbrand's raised dead pile. The thing is, it's weird, because you can raise dead demon piles, right? Is that how that works? Xyphos needs a nerf? Yeah, we've been asking for that since Warhammer 1, and CA just... they haven't been able to do it. They just keep nerfing Wood Elves, but Xyphos just keep... he's a menace. He hasn't been playing as much recently, though, but honestly, for someone who doesn't practice Warhammer, he can get into the semis of a tournament easily. It's insane. But there you go. You can see the Wood Elves. A decent shot on the melee strats for Wood Elves, but it seems like Tomb King's a little bit too much of a menace for them. GG! Well played turn, but we still have many more to go, so stay tuned. And it's looking like, yeah, Tomb Guard are a menace. Look at those value stats. Now game number three against Turin. Now, I gotta explain myself real quick. So for many of you guys, you know white line camping, historically, pretty bad when it comes to Warhammer multiplayer. Many of you guys have known from ages of old that Master Corner Camper has been a menace in the community since for a while now. And given that this Black Arc map for Domination does let you deploy so close to the edge of the map, I had to test it out, right? We gotta see if it's possible, right? Come on, you gotta try it out at least once. And in this case, it's gonna be a double cannon. Tons of crossbowmen gonna be trying to hold down this area. Turin picking up the Empire, and generally we sort of agreed this would likely be a bad matchup for Turin. Honestly, he ran into a lot of bad matchups for this training spree, so we'll see how that sort of pans out. But overall, I would say this should be an interesting battle. Now, in this case, Turin hasn't brought any artillery, sort of conceding that to me and going for skirmishers instead. But we've brought the dreaded war balloons, and they're going to be able to poke things down quite well. Optimus Pine saying, my camera's so high, it occasionally gets obstructed by birds. Yes, yes it does. Look, if you guys want zoom ins, watch turret. You know, my niche is playing from the stratosphere, I guess. What am I watching? You're watching me test? Look, if here's the thing. Honor is not the place of beta testers. I am doing you guys a favor here. Because if I can make Turin suffer enough with this playstyle, CA will actually do something about it. You know? This is my campaign, okay, for getting elected. Look. We must do the terrible things that others will not. So that others can fix them. This is a terrible campaign. Anyways, the thing is, right, as a pseudo beta tester in this situation for Creative Assembly, if I don't do disgusting things like this, it will make it into the actual build. And of course, nobody wants that. So I get a free excuse to corner camp. Anyways, Turin was totally fine with it in battle, as he did have some shenanigans to try and shut it down. As you can see, I can only capture one point. But I'm playing mostly for value today. And Tissy for president, that was a terrible speech. I think we can all agree. I didn't know where I was going with that. I'll work on my speech abilities sometime eventually, but for now we'll settle for less. Volkmar, classic Volkmar, for those of you that haven't been keeping up. He does have his own faction now, though sadly Turin going for the classic Empire colors. Volkmar is pretty scary, but I do have cannons, and Volkmar, he does not enjoy that in the slightest. The slow gonna be making it much harder to dodge, and the war balloons, yes indeed, I am going for the spin strat to maximize their damage. It's gonna be great. Obese chicken saying turn off clouds, that would be, imagine if Creative Assembly added that as an option. But yeah, this game's a necessary evil indeed. And yeah, we're gonna be dancing with the war balloons. He does get a good Vanguard summon. I was talking with Turin. He actually said Free Company Militia might become meta for the Empire simply because they have Vanguard. And I would honestly agree. I think that's not a terrible idea. Those spears slipping on in, they do brace for the charge for my cavalry, but they're still taking decent damage and a nice play. Light Wizard shutting down the War Balloon. I don't really have units to defend against that. The crossbows are too busy right now. So pretty good. And look at that. A summon of Reichsguard Knights, ROR, slipping through my lines and diving right for my range. And this is a pretty big problem. Cathay lacks armor piercing pretty heavily. It's going to be pretty rough. And Tisty, remember there's a hotkey for spinning your units? Oh, actually, yeah, about face. That's actually hilarious. I should do that. Oh my gosh. Rax Zen saying, hey man, don't catch streams often, but love your content. Thank you, man. Yeah, happy to have you here on stream. For anyone who has tuned in over the last while, I do stream very often. Check me out at around this time if you want to watch me crush it at multiplayer. As you can see, I play a lot of multiplayer, so we do have some practice here. But Reichsguard Knights, they're going to be just tearing into me right now. I don't have the ROR Long Mariders. They just didn't make it into this build, sadly. So that means those Reichsguard are going to be pretty difficult. I turn all of my crossbows to deal with them, as that's basically my only armor piercing. And now we're worried a bit, but like I said earlier, Cathay did get a bit of a side buff because all units sort of capture at about the same speed now. This means cavalry can actually capture points in a decent amount of time compared to before. And with a triple cavalry summon, I will actually be able to steal point number 3. From Turin. That should get me a pretty good lead in victory tickets, and meanwhile on the value side of things, we're already pretty good. Most of it's on Volkmar though, so none of that really matters until he dies. Still though, my cannons are doing pretty good damage, the crossbows are focusing him down, and the balloons are doing decent damage right now. They've used about like a third of their ammo. Once they get to about half or three quarters, they're feeling a bit better. The grind continues though. My Jade Warriors do fare pretty well into Empire Swordsmen because of their high damage. I'm gonna cast a Blossom Wind on those Swordsmen. Will it actually hit? Yeah, it's so close, but it doesn't really do that much damage. Blossom Wind continues to be one of the worst spells I've ever imagined because it takes about like 7 seconds for it to actually cast. And that's barely an exaggeration. Rack Zen singing Tissy, do you know when we're going to see Immortal Empire's campaign in Warhammer 3? I do not. Yeah, unfortunately. I just assume I know as much as you guys know that CA has made public. Because even if I did know, I wouldn't say, obviously. NDAs and such. But as you can see over here, the value trading is going very well for me now. Volkmar is on his last legs. A little bit more damage before he's down. I finally killed a Reichsguard Knight. Took about 4 minutes. But I'm feeling pretty confident here. You can see turns actually starting to run out of units, and this is where Cathay has sort of the best chance of winning, as all I have to do now is win back the capture points. And as we've seen before, Cathay generally is pretty bad at stealing capture points, so we'll see how it pans out. I do have a little bit of infantry on the far point, and I do have some reinforcements capturing the close point. In fact, Turin didn't even steal it. I barely managed to hold that, and that's going to be really big for me because capture points are so valuable for poor Cathay. Are you allowed to play Beastmen? The answer is yes, though I don't know if I have any Beastmen games just yet. Blossomwind takes even longer than the High Elf one to land. Oh yeah, the Phoenix one? I forget what it's called because no one plays High Elves. Cathay cannons have the best sound design. Oh my gosh. CA, if they know how to do something right, it's definitely artillery. Cathay cannons is peak artillery, and they finally do kill Volkmar. Yeah, the weightiness of the sound design for Warhammer is so good. I love it, man. What were the two losing matchups? I lost one against Sotek playing as dwarves into his lizardmen, and I lost against Dov plays with his chaos, trying to beat him with dark elves. So pretty nice matches, and two guys that you should definitely check out. Definitely check out their channels. Order Tide or Chaos Tide? My vote's on Chaos Tide. If CA is going to make something broken, it's probably going to be the Chaos Tide, right? Like, there's no way we get another Order Tide campaign when IE launches, right? Right? We'll see. Have you seen Legend's latest video? I've heard about it. It's the OP Beastmen spell, right? The Devolve or what have you. Are Flyers still zero capture weight? That's correct. Flyers do not capture, as that would be a little bit intense because you could just spam only flyers. But over here you can see my cavalry now finally charging into the backs of the spears. They won't get their charge bonus, which is great. I'm sending one unit of infantry to attack point number 3. This is not actually going to capture it. It's just there to force Turin to respond. This will make it easier to steal point number 2, and generally should be a good thing for me. Warriors of Chaos did get buffed. Yeah, Warriors of Chaos are looking pretty good. They're looking pretty nice. They also have access to Bellacor. And Bellacor is sort of busted. Sort of insanely busted. CA Mitch said that the Beastman spell is already fixed. Well, there you go. Yeah. Unfortunately, Creative Assembly... What? Creative Assembly's working on Immortal Empires? Who would have guessed? Who would have guessed? Yeah, it seems like they're doing a pretty good job. I'm sort of liking Creative Assembly and how they're sort of letting us know that these things are being worked on. At least assuming you're not lying to me, Twitch chat, which you never know. I'm looking at YouTube. Literally, the last 6 messages are ats towards me. Intissi, do summons capture? No, Intissi. Gotta say, you're amazed how I play with my mouse, with my hands off the mouse. Yeah, it's amazing, man. Are you allowed to live stream games? No, we have to pre-record. Yeah. It's fine, though. It more or less gets there. Not like there's many people playing on ladder. There's literally no one on the ladder right now, so it wouldn't really matter. Intissi, can you check out my question? I think you missed it. Dude, there's a million questions. Dead like me. Let's see. If I scroll up, I can't find it, man. Hopefully someone in chat gets to you. Phil saying, any chance you using your clout with CA to get them to add landing and melee combat for war balloons? That's a pretty good idea. Phoenix and Twitch saying we never lie. I believe that. totally. But yeah, no, totally. Of course. Why would I not use my clout to get CA to make changes that I want? That's the sole reason why I became a content creator, obviously, so that I can get them to buff Vampire Coast Death Guard. Guys, I'm telling you right now, Death Guard and Bloated Corpses, Creative Assembly, if you are watching, behold, over 800 viewers. That's like, you know, that's like a decent portion of your income, right? You know, if you make them happy and buff Depth Guard, then maybe they'll buy all the DLCs. I don't know. I don't know, but look at them. Look, see? See, Virtual Magi saying Depth Guard are meta here, right? Because they're terrible everywhere else. I have tons of people that totally agree with me that you should buff them. Also, I missed me winning the game, but we had a pretty good lead here. Another win versus Turin. I'm tryharding against some guys, if you couldn't tell. But hey, you know, if we gotta get some losses against him, because he's a terrifying player against many of the other content creators. Yeah, see, Twitch chat's talking about buffing Depth Guard. The YouTube chat's saying we have money. See, look at that. Look at that, Creative Assembly. Hear me. I feel like, you know what this feels like? It feels like I'm Yuri screaming at the Chaos Gods to do something. And then they're gonna snipe me from orbit, just like that Bellacore cinematic, where they just delete him. It's gonna be terrifying. Oh man, yo, I gotta say, best Warhammer cinematic, Bellacore getting deleted, amazing. But yeah, I gotta say, see, Creative Assembly really are the Chaos Gods. Yeah, answer me! Someone from CA, if they type in chat, that would be sick. And Tisty, he's gone mad with imaginary power, yeah. Yeah, I'll pretend that I have influence. It'll be glorious. Do Chosen have ITP? No, not yet. Yeah, Chosen are still sort of weak. Hey, look at that. For those of you guys that wanted Beastmen, boom, there you go. Turin playing a little bit of Beastmen action. We got the Beastie Boys. They're coming on in. Hopefully, they put up a pretty good fight. I got high hopes. I think odds are fairly likely that they'll be able to do okay. And Tissy, do you like Kislev? I love Kislev. Look, like, come on. What do you take me for? A melee guru? Come on, I grew up on Vampire Coast. And Kislev is like gun lines into the horizon. So, yeah, no, I love him. The leadership holding on them too is great. It's amazing. Yeah, because they basically hold for an extra 30 seconds and then some. And it just buys you so many volleys of fire. It's really hard for factions to try and break their range lines. Yeah, melee? Come on, we don't need that here. Unbreakable gun lines. Here we go. Now, starting off, we're going to Windspell Turin. Punish him a little bit, as he had quite a lot of infantry there. Kislev does actually have pretty good wind magic abilities, but only against light armor, which makes it really only good against Beastmen and Slaanesh. You'll also notice this is literally my anti-Slaanesh build. And the reason is because I figure Beastmen are more or less the same as them. Are dogs redundant against Kislev on land battles? I would say you probably don't need dogs against Kislev, as generally they're not actually going to be routing most of the time, so dogs don't have too many targets. Garlic, peace out. We'll have the VODs up, so feel free to tune in for that later. Yeah, Kislev better than Vampire Coast? Well, they're more meta, but I wouldn't say better. Anyways, we're seeing a very nice engagement on the right flank. I'm sending in my chariots and my cavalry to get a bit of hammer and anvil over there. And as you'll notice, my cavalry do actually hold the point. The reason being, because of the capture weight changes, melee rush builds that sort of hang around and stall have a much harder time sealing points. And generally, that's going to be good for me. But the ROR Minotaurs do get in there, and the Butchers of Kalkengard, they're going to be doing a lot of damage. Yeah, and that's sort of the roughest part here that makes them different from Slaanesh. They do have a little bit of armor, which is scary. What about multiplayer campaigns? I do have a thing scheduled with Flying Taco, but right now I'm sort of doing less of that since videos are doing a little bit better right now. Though it's sort of on the list. It really depends on if I can get a format that makes them work for YouTube. Obese chicken with the money for the money god. Truly, CA. If they are one thing, that might be it. Now, in general, you can see here, fight's going pretty well. I'm getting huge wind blast with my caster. Really, really nice for her. You'll also notice that I have two casters to cover both points. This is a fairly strong strategy. Would highly recommend it. And overall, we've routed the Beastmen in the middle. But the problem is that they are doing pretty well on my far point. And if the fighting keeps going on like this, I would presume a double cap would ensue, and it'd generally be a pretty bad time. So we'll see how long I can hold that area, but it really all hinges on how well I can hold there, since I do finally have the middle. And to see when will Immortal Empire start, I think Creative Assembly announced when it will come up. So from various news sources, you should have the date. So feel free to check those out. You know, Reddit, check out Lore Master of Sotek. I bet he already has a video. Maybe Daw, Turin, any one of the guys that I've played against today. So for the point number one, against all odds, I've actually managed to hold it against a Beastman push. One of the changes to Domination, slowing down capture rates, did actually make Kislev stronger. And actually many ranged factions should be stronger in Domination, which is a good sign for Cathay. Though I think they'll still be weak. Same with High Elves. In the meantime, I've noticed that my trading is fairly even here. Fairly even. So I, for a second, looked at Turin's Far Point, but decided not to send units there. Because if you're trading badly, you generally don't want to split up onto separate points. Though, it is undefended, so I'm going to go for it anyways. Generally, I would say that's a bad idea. It's usually better to reinforce in middle, but we're going to have a bit of fun here and see if we can steal it. In the meantime, Harpies, you'll notice, much less scary than Furies because they do way less damage. And actually, I would say one of the strongest tools for demon factions. Harpies... like, Furies are just so much stronger than Harpies, it's disgusting. And that might be the thing that keeps demon factions fairly meta as we head on into Immortal Empires. Someone's saying, do expendable units have lower capture weight? They do! Creative Assembly changed it, so they have 25% less capture weight than normal infantry. Yeah. And same with single entities, they have less capture weight. But cavalry have the same capture weight as infantry now. And you can see sort of me getting punished for sending my units onto that far point. My middle point will now be falling. But perhaps that's okay. If I can steal point number three, then I should be alright. You'll notice I summoned a snow leopard because I don't know yet that the capture weights have changed. So a bit of a misplay there, but it will still help me cap. How well do you think Kalita on a Necro Serpent will perform in Domination? I will say decently. Decently. It depends on how much damage he does, though. Yeah, Goblins, Bretonian Presence, and Skaven Slaves will all capture slightly slower, but not enough for it to really matter. It'll only matter in a handful of games. But in general, everybody, you can think of it as everyone has the same capture weight, and capping is slightly slower. So there's a little bit less sort of maneuvering to steal points, though. As you can see here, there is a little bit of it if you do leave your points undefended. Nice. So, as for the rest of the battle, we are seeing trading going still pretty well for me. But Moger and the Butchers of Kalkengard have gone quite a bit of healing. So you'll notice the army sizes are actually still pretty close. This is a bit of a tight game, I would say. Check the Total War website. Yeah, there's going to be news everywhere, guys. Honestly, I'm not really a big news channel, so you're probably better off checking other places. And, yeah, as soon as the stream ends, you'll be able to do that. Well, I guess you could do it now, but, you know. Yeah, well, I'll send you guys off, since mostly I'm just here to cover some fun games, do a bit of competitive multiplayer, do a bit of wind farming, and have some good fun. Have I talked about how good trolls are with regeneration? Trolls are pretty good now. Yeah, they got a pretty significant increase to healing from Warhammer 2, but because they rout so easily, they're not great in Dom. I would say in land battles, though, they're pretty nice. Pretty nice. Also, the Vargulf lost its regeneration. It now has the Hunger, which is twice as fast, but only activates in melee. For any of you Vargulf mains, I guess. Do you ever do head-to-heads? Yeah, I have a few head-to-heads. You can find some VODs down below. As for the battle, you'll notice I've shifted my focus. I'm basically only fighting in the middle and Terran's far point. I've conceded the point closer to me because I know if I just hold 2 points, I should be able to win the game. Yeah, people are saying August 23rd, a little over a month away, and we'll all have Immortal Empires. Giants still suck? Yeah, Giants still suck. I think, anyways. Yeah, you're not allowed to leave until my stream is over. There you go. You got there. Now, At this point, it's looking like trading's going fairly well enough where I can start contesting all of the points. So I'm feeling pretty good about this fight. Though, Beastmen do have Vanguard everywhere. They can mobilize extremely quickly. So there's always a chance Turin sort of recaps very quickly. Plus, my Lord did just die. And as many of you guys know, that is a common changing point for these types of battles. So that's going to be pretty rough. My leadership is taking a huge hit. Thankfully, we're Kislev, so we don't really care about leadership. So much easier to comment when it's pre-recorded. I know, it's amazing. It's amazing. It does lose a little bit of the charm when you have pre-recorded, though. I feel like it's a bit nicer playing it live. So I'll switch to live as soon as I'm able to. Yeah, Giants could be a little bit better, I would say. But yeah, at this point, he just has Mogra on point number one. I'm blocking him with a single unit of infantry. On the far point, capturing is quite slow. So even though he has a single Gore Herd moving there to cap it, it's gonna take quite a while, and I'll likely win the game before then. Why nobody uses War Wagons in multiplayer? Just because normal mortars are better. The War Wagon mortars, it gives you mobility for a unit that doesn't need mobility. It's sort of awkward, because mortars, they'll perform just as well no matter where they are. The only difference is that it's a tiny little bit tankier, but, you know, maybe one day if I do a wind farming stream, I'll go for the mortars. You wish dwarves got better runes or something? That would be cool. I would be down to see some better runes on dwarves. They're honestly pretty weak. A lot of them are buffs, but they don't really last that long. But yeah, at this point we have a triple cap on Turin. We've done it. We've defeated his Beastmen. A lot of people say Beastmen can be quite scary in Dom because of their quick capture rates and vanguards. But because Domination is so much more about a trading game now, I think they might have a bit of a harder time. Not saying that Beastmen can't trade though, but it looks like that's gonna be it. Hope you guys had a wonderful day today. I guess since we are at the end of the stream, I will bring this up because this is a pretty nice time to, I guess. Exzola, if you want to support the channel and you haven't bought Warhammer 3 yet, Creative Assembly set this up for me so that if you buy using the link, it actually supports the channel a ton. I get a percentage of whatever DLCs you buy. So if you haven't gone and bought Immortal Empires yet or are missing DLCs, consider that if you want to help the channel or not. You can do whatever you want, really. But I do feel like I have to bring that up because YouTubing is a career. Other than that, though, Immortal Empires is great. I'm going to be posting videos every single day on various different topics for Immortal Empires. So feel free to leave comments if you want to on what you want me to cover. And I think that's basically it. Hopefully I see you soon for another wind farming video. And I'll have another short video tomorrow. Peace. Wonderful stream. Amazing stream.